I started out a graduate of Delaware State, very proud of that, and came home and decided that it was time to get a job. And one day I opened up the paper and it said, you can earn a lot of money selling automobiles. And I said, oh, that's pretty interesting. And I went to my dad and I said, hey, listen, I'm gonna go. I was kind of working for my father, who has in his own right worked real hard and is an attorney in New Jersey. And I said, hey, listen, I'm gonna go sell cars. He looked at me like, wait a minute, because my brother ended up going to law school, but I was really done with school at that point. So I started selling cars and really fell in love with the car business. And I love it so much that I worked myself through. So all through my 20s, I remember missing my friends' weddings and all the things that were going on in your 20s, because I worked really basically almost 6 days a week in the car business, long hours. But I went from salesman to sales manager to general manager of a very large Chevrolet dealership. I went to my parents and I said, I have always had a dream of owning my own franchise. I said, it requires a certain amount of capital. My parents decided that they were going to take everything they had, which was to mortgage their home, and invest it in me. So at 29 years old, I became a Ford dealer. And then one day I'm riding through the mountains of northeastern Pennsylvania, and a phone call came from someone in Atlanta. And they said, hey, Steve, you know, we have designated a facility down there to be a minority point, and we're looking for the best dealer we can find. And we picked up and we moved to Smyrna, Georgia, where we opened Wade Ford. Wade Ford had been in Atlanta since 1933. We've been operating this franchise from 2002 to now. I had some mentors. And one of my mentors, since I got in the car business, was a board of trustee member of Clark Atlanta University. His name is Bill Shack. And Bill is a very, very important partner to me, and a friend and an advisor. And Bill very quickly told the school that, hey, we have a minority dealer. If we're gonna do any vehicles, we need to at least give him an opportunity to have a chance to sell us cars. And then he called me back and said, hey boy, you better sell them cars cheap to the school. And that was important to me because that was the case. The school hired another friend of mine, Darrell Walker, Coach. And Coach was in the NBA, just a wonderful guy, happens to be a Kappa fraternity friend, brother of mine, that helped too. And when I went down to visit Darrell, he walked me around the facility and I walked in and I saw the locker room. I said, my goodness. I said, we have to do something, Darrell, because you're new and let's get behind it. So the athletic director, Mr. Dawson, was all behind it and said, let's go do this. And they really made it easy to do. So it kind of was a great way for me to get involved with Clark Atlanta. And I really, really love the energy there. And I think that it's one of those things in my life that I'm kind of put on my checklist that annually, what is next? How can you help this next generation of young men and women that I see on that campus that really, really are exactly where I was, you know, dreaming about what's next? And if somebody supports them, and we need to do that, more of us need to do that.